and gentlemen, welcome. How's everybody?
Good.
Good.
Is it on?
Yes.
So, thank you all for coming. The students and the faculty who have been involved in this have worked really hard to put together this awesome evening for you guys, and I hope you have so much fun. Welcome to ISI's Jukebox at ITG. We'll be playing some really classic songs, so if you feel so inclined, don't be afraid to get up, go on the aisle, go in the front, start dancing. You sit with your dad, Stacey. Now we got that out of the way. We start in the 60s. The first song that we're going to be singing, Mom, you weren't even born when this song was released. I'm going to hear it at home tonight. So our first song was written in 1961 and was first performed by the rhythm and blues duo, The Top Notes. This song has graced the charts many times, many, many different covers by many different artists, including those like The Who. But you probably know this song most for its iteration by The Beatles. This song was probably The Beatles' first major, major hit. It's Twist and Shout.
Sorry, a little technical difficulties. Hi, everybody. How's it going?
It is considered the sixth best song in American film, a film by the American Film Society, and it also won the Grammy for Record of the Year in 1969. This is Mrs. Robinson. Oh, almost forgot.
and we'd like to welcome, coming out of retirement for this one evening, Mr. Garner. Hippies and Vietnam and what is that in the 70s? Disco? Ooh, if we had time, I'd show you the electric shuffle. Just saying. So, our next song, what is our next song? Our next song was written in 1971 and is probably John Denver's most recognizable tune. This song is also, oddly, the official song of the state of West Virginia, if you didn't know that. Weird fact. This song peaked at number 2 in the Hot 100 in the US, and you all should recognize this song. It is Take Me Home, Country Road.
How's everyone's evening so far?
Almost 10.
also released in 1971. David Bowie's Life on Mars was in his groundbreaking album, Hunky Dory. The song reached number one in the UK and number three in the United States. Famous music critic Neil McCormick has gone on record saying it is the greatest piece of music ever written. Life on Mars.
Joel, when he worked in L.A. as a pianist in a lounge. The song was his first single and the name of his first album, and it peaked at number 25 on the Top 100. The song did not gain its major popularity until the release of his next album, and has since become Billy Joel's most recognizable tune, Piano Man.
Feeling alright.
written in the height of the disco craze in the late 70s. Earth, Wind, and Fire's hit song, September, peaked at number 8 in the US and number 3 in the UK. The song has remained very popular, especially in England, where it is used by sports and different memes all the time. Most lately, the song was used by the 2018 men's national team in England to, you know, celebrate their surprise run to the World Cup quarterfinals.
In the 80s. 80s were awesome. I don't know what you're talking about.
Well,
I wasn't there. So first, released in 1981, this famous Hall & Oates song reached number five on the top 100. But this song has stayed in pop culture through its use in a lot of movies, including The Wedding Singer, Dumb and Dumber, Step Brothers, 500 Days of Summer, Eddie the Eagle, and Ready Player One. The song is also used in eHarmony and Applebee's ads, if like you're into any of those. So performing Hall & Oates classic. Here you go. Currently has it as the 356th best song ever written. It is Sweet Dreams.
Work hard, man. Slow down. Make sure you're nice and lucky. Make sure
dressing broken. Have fun. Goodbye.
Thank you.
By the late, great George Michaels. This song was on Wham's 1984 album, but the song was written, sung, everything by George himself. And the song reached number one in 25 different countries, and it features a uber famous saxophone solo that I feel like that's one of those things all saxophonists have to play this solo.
Waste.
Jim Carrey's the Riddler. Do you know those two hated each other and will never do a movie with each other again? It's my Wendy Williams moment of the night. So this is Kiss from a Rose.
Da 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 da.
Next up, we have Wonderwall, which is written and performed by the famous British band Oasis. This track was released in 1995 and went triple platinum, reaching fifth in the US and number two in Great Britain. This song, like you young kids, you might remember it from like 2012, I think it was 2012, the London Olympics. They sang it at the London Olympics, and if you can remember it, the guy who sang it, he was like eating his microphone. That's what I remember about the song. Like he was eating his microphone. I thought that was really, really weird. So this is Wonderwall.
About you now, and all
So now we move into the 2000s, but our jukebox time machine has hit a problem. Y2K. So we're gonna have to take a 10 minute break to figure out Y2K. So we'll take a little 10 minute intermission, buy some snacks, have some, you know, talk to some people, go to the restroom. I know that's what I will be doing. So we will see you in 10 minutes. So, Vanessa Carlton's 2002 hit, 1,000 Miles, became a pop sensation in 2002. And, you know the one with the really catchy piano? It was critically acclaimed for its use of piano and violin, and it was the only one of her songs to ever reach the top 100 in the U.S. This is Vanessa Carlton's 1,000 Miles.
Tonight.
rehearse this morning, and I've not been able to get that out of my head all day. So our next song, Coldplay's chart-topping, Grammy-winning song, Viva La Vida, has gone on to become the band's most recognizable and commercially successful hit. Now think about that, because that's Coldplay. Coldplay's got like every popular song in the last 10 years. Like, they're pretty big. This is the fourth song in history to reach more than 4,000 digital downloads. Viva La Vida. Feel the fear in my enemy's eyes. Listen as the crowd would sing. So Maroon 5's song Sunday Morning, released in some year, only reached 31st in the US and 24th in Britain, which is, you know, not that high. But it has gone on to be one of the most memorable and most critically acclaimed songs in all of Maroon 5's top charting, like, list. It's just a list of songs. Making her the first female British artist to ever do so. The song Someone Like You has reached 17 million in digital downloads, making it one of the most bought digital songs in history.
look pretty weird.
Like, I got some paint on my face. I went and put some paint on my face. Because the next song is somebody that I used to know. Have any of you seen that video? You know that video with Gautier? He's got the covered in paint. Well, I love this song. So I wanted it to, I wanted it to be Gautier. So I went and got my face painted. No apologies. So this song, somebody that I used to know, reached the top 10 in 30 different countries. The song won a Grammy, and it has sold 13 million digital copies. A real hit for Gautier. Too bad he stopped making music.
Now and then I think of when we were together, like when you said you felt so happy you could die. That you were right for me, but felt so lonely in your company. But that was love, and it's an ache I still remember.
Somebody that I used to.
That song was written in, what, 2011? In 2011. I would have moved to Indiana that year. Or maybe the year before, I don't know. Well, that is our last song for you. But, Miss Choi, we have a little surprise for you. So I'd like to hand this off to Olivia Reed, and she will talk for a second, and then we will give you our surprise.
Olivia Schroeder is going to talk for a second.
Miss Choi has been my music teacher since the seventh grade, so that's about 5 or 6 years. I can't really do math right now, but she's meant a lot to me. We all of us on stage decided to take Harlow Music these past 2 years, and we just wanted to commemorate that with a song.
Waking up is early enough. thank you for the last amazing 5 years. There's some other people that we need to thank for this evening. First, we want to thank the crew who you didn't see, who made this all look like this, kept yelling at me to get on stage because I was going to be late, and made sure that everything sounded and looked the way it did. I just want to thank them. If you give a quick round of applause to our crew. I also want to thank all of our performers. You all have put in so much work after school, during class, during lunch. Y'all have put in so much work towards this. Thank you all so much for all the work. And of course, we gotta say thank you to the parents for letting us stay at school a little bit later and letting us stay late on a Friday. I mean, what parent wants to be at school on a Friday? Thank you, parents, so much. We also would like to thank our former head of school, Mr. Garner, for coming back, coming out of retirement. The music is always so much better when you're playing guitar with us. Thank you so much. We'd also like to thank a couple of parents. There's Dana Schroeder. There's Jennifer Reed, and there's Shirin Vakili. We'd like to, I said that wrong, didn't I? Oh, I said it right. I was nervous about that one. Thank you all so much for running and doing our concession stand for us. They were in charge of all the goodies that you should have eaten. And we also want to thank Asher Lynch for letting us use this black box, for always letting us use the black box, even when she's trying to prepare for a show in 2 weeks and having to move the set pieces around and crazy and dealing with these people all day.
It's tough.
And thank you for, you know, helping us with the sound system and helping us with all you do. Thank you, Asha. But most importantly, thank you, Miss Choi, for everything you have done.